Hi, sweet friends, welcome back and thanks for joining me today. Now we're going to be decorating our dining room for Christmas. Now in this room, I decided to go with flock decor. So I'm excited to see how that's going to turn out, but I'm going to still incorporate my traditional colors of red and green and whites and gold. Now, if you are new, hi, my name is Amy and welcome. This is actually my 6th video in my Christmas decorating series. So if you happen to miss any of those, I'll go ahead and link that down below so you can go and check that out after you're done watching today's video. Now we have tons of things to get done today, so we better get started. Make sure to give me a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Today, we're starting out with a blank canvas. And if you're new here, what I like to do is to strip away all my decor, clean down the surfaces, and then start decorating. If you don't already do that, I would totally recommend it, even if you plan to use the same decor. Today, we'll be decorating our farmhouse hutch, our sideboard, adding some new wall art, decorating some wall hooks, and also doing a very simple tablescape. Now, as we get a little closer to Christmas, I'll share with you a more elaborate one, so if you'd like to see that, definitely let me know down in the comments. As you can see, I've already went ahead and decorated this tree. It is a new one for this year. It is a 7-foot Prince flocked artificial Christmas tree from the King of Christmas. Now, if you're looking for more Christmas tree inspiration, I'll link the 2 videos that I've already shared with you where I decorated our Christmas trees in our family room as well as in our kitchen. Let's start out today first by hanging the new art piece that I picked up from Hobby Lobby early in the season, so I'm excited to finally hang it where I had envisioned it going all along.
Gaze upon the sky, Christmas on my mind, somewhere from a place up high above. There's a song of love traveling afar, seeking us to warm up every heart.
As you all know, I love to decorate tiered trays, and I love the look of placing one here on our sideboard. Today, I'll be adding this 3-tiered tray from Hobby Lobby. So once again, I was inspired by Crystal Terra's tiered trays. So I'm going to be using different Target houses amongst some Target Dollar Spot things that I just picked up to create a really unique village idea, much like she did. So if you're looking for other tiered tray ideas, definitely go check out her channel. She just did 3 different tiered trays for Christmas. She does the best tiered trays around, and I know you would love her. I have a few tips for you when you're decorating your tiered trays. Number one, don't get frustrated. Sometimes they can be a little bit difficult, but just have fun, play around with the decor. If you need a break, step back, come back, and you'll be even more creative. The second tip I have for you is to have little risers, either wood rounds or use something that will elevate your decor. What I'm using are Jenga blocks that I actually painted, so you could either paint them or stain them, and whatever that is, it just gives your decor a boost, and it just makes everything a little bit more easy to see and gives your tray even more dimension to look at.
To be your light into the night, bless us with a moment of serenity. Joyful Christmas news, hope will find its way to you. Peaceful little lights, Christmas on my mind, from a place up high above. There there's a special star shining from afar, seeking us to warm up every heart, to be our light into the night. Bless us with a moment of surrender.
Typically, I like to balance the decor on each side of the buffet, but since the tree is right there, I'm going to be creating a little bit of a smaller vignette, and I'm going to be incorporating elements that I used over in our tiered tray, like some wooden elements, the trees, as well as a white house that I actually spray painted to make more neutral. I'll go ahead and link that video down below for you. It is full of other DIY Christmas decor you might want to check out. To the wooden arch that is from Kirkland's, I'm going to add a wreath that I actually combined two separate wreaths to get the look that I was after. The flocked wreath was from Walmart and the magnolia berry wreath was from At Home. Here is another area in our dining room that I love to decorate and add seasonal decor. These accordion style hooks are from Decor Steals and are one of my favorites to decorate. To them, I'll be adding various kitchen essentials to just add something a little special to the wall that would otherwise be just blank and boring. That first wall plaque I actually got from Walmart last year and is one of my favorite pieces. I love that it shows the true meaning of Christmas, which is Jesus's birth. And that is the most important and the reason I celebrate the season. Now, if you're new to my channel, I love to share daily Bible verses. So today's Bible verse comes from 1 Corinthians 34 and it reads, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever." Like I mentioned before, today's tablescape is going to be super simple. I'm adding this beautiful table runner from the Hearth and Hand line at Target, and I just love that plaid and how the red really pops. Then I'm going to be adding these beautiful oil lamps that my dad gave me. They were just sitting out in one of his old buildings, so we cleaned them up and I just absolutely love them. So I'm going to display one on each side of a simple Christmas tray arrangement. I'm going to add some pine stems from Hobby Lobby and a colorful assortment of Christmas bulbs. Now this is going to create a simple, cheerful Christmas centerpiece for everyday use. Remember, as Christmas gets a little closer, I will be sharing with you a full, more elaborate tablescape. So if you're interested in that, let me know down in the comments. Thank you.
If you remember, we did a huge makeover of our dining room last year, so this is actually the first time that I'm getting to decorate it for Christmas. And I have to say, I am having a blast. So the last furniture piece that I have to decorate is our farmhouse hutch. Now, I scored this piece off of Facebook Marketplace for only $100. It was in great shape, but I wanted to try my hand at some chalk paint, so I went ahead and chalk painted it the Rust-Oleum cream chiffon color, and I just love how it turned out. Now, you might notice that we recently removed the railing to the top shelf so that I can easily decorate them. So for this top shelf, I'm using this Merry Christmas black iron piece that I found at home, and then to each side I'm adding these tiered flock trees to tie in with the other elements from the room, and they were from Walmart. To take center stage on the second shelf, I'm adding our nativity set from Kirkland's that I got years ago and placing them into this nativity stable that I just picked up from Hobby Lobby. I also wanted to add just splashes of black and red throughout the cabinet, so I'll be adding pieces all from Target to accomplish just that. For the bottom shelf, I thought it would be fun to incorporate some baking items, so I'm using a cutting board to ground the space. Then I'm adding a large jar that I'm going to fill with some gingerbread cookies that I picked up from Target. Now, I realize I probably should have bought a couple more cookie bags to fill it, maybe even three, but for now I think they look really adorable, and I did taste test them and they're pretty tasty, so I would highly recommend picking some up if you're at Target. Then I'm going to add an antique vintage scale and a rolling pin with a black plate topped with a wreath and then some measuring cups that I found from Hobby Lobby. To the top, I always love to use this vintage looking scale from Decor Steals that I pretty much have up here year round. And then to balance it off, I'm going to use some larger, taller pieces in a group of three. To the scale, I'm going to add these beautiful hammered glass bowls that I got from Southern Living at Home when I was a consultant. To them, I'm going to add some Epsom salts to take on the appearance of snow. And finally, I'll place a battery-powered flickering candle to each, which will create a beautiful ambiance to the hutch.
Okay.
Okay, well that does it for today's Christmas decorating here in our dining room. Let's quickly remember what the room looked like before, all bare and lonely, followed by after, which is enhanced by all the beautiful Christmas decor. I hope that you enjoyed watching and that I gave you some new ideas for decorating your home for Christmas this year. If I did, go ahead and let me know down in the comments. And as always, remember to give me a big thumbs up and consider subscribing before you go. Also, you have to let me know if you've already started decorating or if you plan to decorate after Thanksgiving. I want to wish each and every one of you a happy Thanksgiving. I hope that you have a relaxing, enjoyable time with your families. I plan to take a teeny little break from decorating, so for Friday's video, I'll be sharing with you part two of Kirkland's Christmas decor. So I hope that you'll meet me back here for that one. Remember, I still have lots of Christmas content still to share with you, including my home tour, which will be coming up in the next few weeks. So thanks so very much for watching. I hope to see you all real soon in my next one. Take care, my friends. God bless and Merry Christmas. Bye.